Okay, I hope you all can hear me, right? Okay, so today I will continue with the lesson that we have already studied last week. That is about the binary tree, right? And today we will focus on I would say that it is important and very useful tree, right? We call the binary tree, and I will go into detail about this one, right? Okay, today's outline will be the binary search tree, right? That we have already experienced that yesterday about how can we construct the binary tree, and then binary tree can be used as the sorted data structure. Okay, you can also use this as the okay, because it is efficient, and so we use it frequently. And today I will talk about the efficient tree, right? Starting from the binary search tree, and then binary search tree is like yesterday we have already experienced that when we have the root node here, right? For example, if we have the number 49. If you have another number, right, to insert into this binary tree, okay, if I want to insert 12 into this tree, 12 is less than 49, so we will go to the left, and then 12 will be added here. And suppose the next node will be 52, right? 52 will be inserted here, right, and the right subtree of this root, okay, and so on, right. So once you want to do the tree traversal, like in order, tree traversal, right? 12 will be print out, 49 and 52, right? And this one will be listed in ascending order. But if you want to print the ascending order elements from this binary tree in ascending order, you have to use the in order tree traversal. But we also have a special kind of the binary search tree that is a threaded binary search tree, as its name, right? You can bring the string from the root into the end of the elements that are going to be printed, and then in this direction or in this string, it will be in ascending order as well. I'm going to talk about this later. And because you want to use the binary search tree, that is to make it the most efficiency of this binary search tree, right? You may have to make the tree balanced. The tree has to be balanced, right? So we have some situation or some cases that if your input is like this, 40, 49, 48, 47, and 46, and so on, right? If your sequence of your numbers or your sequence of your elements has been already sorted, if it has already been sorted, your tree will be like this, right? So if your tree will be like this, it will look like a linked list, not a tree, and it's not balanced as well. So what you have to do is you have to make use of the AVL tree or balanced tree, right? It will be automatically balanced a tree by itself, but we are going to talk about this into detail later, okay? And this one will be the topics that we are going to talk today. Okay, I will quickly talk about the first one. This is the binary search tree. As I've just told you, right, a binary search tree can be known that as an ordered binary tree. Okay, and it is a variant of binary tree in which the nodes are arranged in order. Okay, for this example, if you are considering 39 here, 39 will be at the root of the binary search tree or BS. Sometimes we can called BST. Okay, and I would like to say that the right subtree, every element in the left subtree will be less than or equal to 39. Okay, this left subtree. Okay, every element 27 or 18, 29, 28, 36, they are all less than 39 here. That is the root. Similarly to the case of the right subtree, right? Every element here 45, 40, 50, 54, 59, 65, 60, they are all greater than or equal to 39. Okay, so this we will call these kinds of the BST binary search tree. And also, right, this left subtree will be less than 27. Okay, less than 27, and so on, right? In binary search tree, all node at in the left subtree, you have the value less than that of the root node. Okay, that I've just shown you. And all the nodes in the right subtree, you have the value that either equal to or greater than the root node. Okay, this is what we call the binary tree. And this will be divided recursively. So recursively in what sense? It means that this one will be less than this one. This one, this subtree will be less than this one. Okay, and when we considering 27, this one will be less than 27, and this subtree will all, the elements in this subtree will all less greater than or equal to 27, and so on. Right? For this example, this one will be greater than, right? This one greater than or equal to 45. Okay, this is very interesting binary tree. Right, because we are going to use this as a, if we perform the in order tree traversal, right, you can get the ascending order sequence of the elements in this tree. Okay, binary search tree also speed up the insertion and deletion of operations, because if your binary search tree is balanced, right, you can have the this like an advantage, because the tree has a speed advantage, right? When the data in the structure changes rapidly. So that's why we can call binary search tree as a efficient data structure, right? Especially when compared with the sorted linear arrays and linked list. Okay, even you have the linked list that has been sorted or linear array that has been sorted, but when compared to the binary search tree, right, this one will be more, the BST is more efficient data structure than the others. Okay, why? In a sorted array, searching can be done in big O, log n base 2 time or complexity. But insertion and deletion are quite expensive because you have to traverse along the array or even you have the sorted array, right? If you want to search, right, you can just simply separate into half and then separate into half and separate into half when you want to search for an element in the array, right? So that's why we use the big O log n base 2, okay? But for the insertion, right, you need to find the place to be inserted. That is right, you can search to the place that you will, suppose you want to insert here, but insertion and deletion will be expensive because once you want to insert here, you have to shift this array back and then shift right, and then you can just simply add the new elements in this section. That would be expensive. Okay, up to now, I think when I explain to you, I think you might be confused. Anyone in this room confused about what I have already talked about? Why the sorted array searching can be done in this log n base 2 time? If you don't understand and want me to explain more, press 1 in the chat box so I can understand that you cannot follow me. Oh, that's good. You all understand about this. Okay, thank you. So, okay, for the sorted array, right? If you want to search, you can use just only log n base 2. And in contrast, inserting and deleting element in the linked list is easier, but searching for the element is done in big O n. Why? The searching is big O n time, because for the linked list you might have to, for the linked list, right, it is not sorted. Okay, it is not sorted. If you want to search for an element, always you have to search all of the elements in the linked list. Okay, you need to search all of the elements in the linked list. If you couldn't find it, right, until the end, right? If you couldn't find it, so you have to compare n time. Always compare n time if you cannot find the elements in this linked list. So that's why for the linked list is not efficient as well. So you will have trade-off, right? Okay, for the array implementation or the linked list implementation. So that's why I suggest you, or I introduce you, the binary search tree or binary tree to be an efficient data structure, right? Why? Because binary search tree for searching, you can use only big O log n base 2. And for inserting, insert and delete, you can also use big O log n base 2 as well. Okay, so that's pretty fast compared to the array or the linked list representations. Okay, for this slide, right, I'm going to show you which one is not, or which one is a binary tree. Okay, for this example, why the left one is not a binary tree? Why this one is not a binary search tree? 20 is more than 21. That's right. Thank you, Lamin. 22 is greater than 21. So where will, if you want to make this correct, where will we put 22 to? What is the correct place of 22? So it's not correct, right? You have to remove this, right? And then put this to here. 22. Left note of 27. Thank you very much. Correct. But you have to put to this. Okay. How about the second one? The second tree here. Is it correct or not? Okay, it's correct. Thank you, Kemanat. It's correct, right? Because this one is less than 21. 28, 27, 39 is less than 21. Okay, and 27, 28, 39. Okay, it's in ascending order. Okay, how about the last one? Oh, they all mix up, right? This one is not correct, right? Okay, 15 and 18 should be moved to this subtree, right? And this one, 42 will be moved to, should be moved to this subtree, right? So how can we collect this one? Oh, if I delete this song, I cannot see this. Okay, this one should be 42, right? It's supposed to be like this. Okay. And this one is still balance tree. Why? How can we know that? We are going to talk about this, whether the tree is balanced or not. Okay, this is, if you want to create a binary search tree using the following data element, right, starting from 45, right? First of all, you have to, 45 will be at the root, and then 39 to the left, and then 56 to the right, and then 12 to the left, and then 34 to the right of 12. And how about 78? 78 will be here to the right of 56. Will be here, and 10 on the left of 12, and 89. Fifty-four. 67. And the last one is 81. Right? It's pretty easy, right? Mm-hmm. If you are the human being, when you see the binary tree, you can insert the new element into the binary search tree easily. But it will be difficult, right? Because we are the computer engineer, right? We have to write a program in order to insert a new element into the tree, right? So you have to do, right? You have to do, and you have already finished this lab yesterday. I think you're good in writing the binary tree already. I hope so. Okay, so this is the way that you will construct a binary tree, right? And the next one, if you want to search a node with the value 67, what shall we do? First of all, what to do is you have to start from the root node. Okay, the root node. And then compare 67 with the 45. But 67 is greater than 45, so you will go to the right hand side. Okay, now we will compare 56 with the 67. 67 is greater than as well. Okay, so you have to go to the right again. So you have to consider 78. 78 is greater than 67, so you will go to the left. And then now here we are 67 is equal to 67, then Okay, found. Okay, this is if you want to search for an element in the binary search tree and then you found the element, so you can stop the process. Okay, so in order to search this, right, and this one, we have element. How many elements in this tree? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, right? Log 11 base 2 is equal to 3 dot something, right? And then we took ceiling, right? So you can get 4. What I'm trying to say is that if you have the binary search tree, the maximum number of comparison will be not greater than this one plus one, will be not greater than 5. So in this way, in this example, the first one, second one, the third comparison, I mean, the second first is a comparison. The number of comparison, this is the first comparison, the second comparison, the third one, and the fourth one, right? Okay, log n base should be plus one. So you can have 3xx, that will be equal to 4, and plus one will be 5. It's not greater than 5 times of the searching comparison. Okay. How about this? Suppose you want to find 40 in this structure, right? You have to compare this one, 45, and then here we go to 39, and we have to go to the right, because we are going to compare with 40, and then we see now. So we can see now, so cannot be found. Okay, so we stop. So what is the number of time that we have to search for 40 and we cannot find it? Just only 2 times. You can see that only 2 times is less than 5, right? Okay. So it's just 2 examples of how to search a found node or not found node, okay? So here we are. This is an algorithm of searching a node in binary tree. So the first step is you have to, if tree point to data is equal to value, right? The current data, the tree. Tree is a pointer to the tree, right? The current node, okay? If tree point to data is equal to value or tree is equal to now, then return tree. Return tree will be the node that has been found. Or if not, you can find now. Now will be not found. So we have only 2 cases, right? If you can find the data that is equivalent to the value or the input value or the given value, so you will return 3, right? That is current position that point to the node, the data, the node with the equivalent data to the value. But if not, if you go to the place that the tree point to now, so it is the element is not found. So you can stop, right? So that's why we can return tree like this. Return tree. Tree could be better found or now. Okay, and then else you have to perform the tree traversal. If the value is less than tree data, if the current value or the given value is less than tree data, so you have to go to the left subtree. Am I right? If the value that you are going to find that is less than the current position data, the data at the current position of the tree, you will go to the left subtree. Otherwise, you will go to the right subtree. And then you can use this recursive algorithm in order to find or recursively find the element inside this tree. Okay, this is pretty easy if you use the binary search tree, right? You can just simply separate the group of elements into two groups, less than the root or greater than the root. Okay. So if you want to implement it by using the C programming, you may have to use this one. This program, right? I'm not going into detail about this because I think you all can write a program this like this program already. Am I right? Did you use this program yesterday? Hello? Are you still with me? We have 67 persons or people here. Okay, in order to make me feel like I'm talking with someone, right? Could you please type 8 into the box, like the chat box, to check for the class attendance? Oh, now it's very fast. When they ask you, are you okay? Are you with me? So you be silent. You are all silent. Okay, I've seen Nannapath. Nannapath, are you okay to turn on your microphone and explain to me about this one, this program, this function? Nannapath? Hello, Nannapath. Because you are the last one who type 8. 3428, Nannapath. Hello, can you turn on your microphone, please? You cannot turn on your microphone. What's happened? Oh, sorry to hear that. Okay, I will shift to Veerapat. Right, Veerapat, you just type 8, the last one. Can you help me to explain this one? Veerapat. Are you here? Okay, if you don't want to help me, so I have to help myself. Okay, this is the one, the program that if you want to insert an element to the data structure. Okay, first of all, you may have to allocate the new node, right? So that's why you have to use this one, malloc, right? New node, right? Of the structure node, right? And then size, you use size of, right? In order to allocate this one. This one is a function to allocate a memory and then return structure node. And don't forget the asterisk or the star, right? Because you want to make this one PTR to be a pointer to this node. And then you assign the value to this node and then left link and right link will be set to now. So, and if the tree is now initialization, right? So you can just simply point tree will point to pointer, right? So in order to do this, right, you can just simply assign pointer, which is an address of the node, assign to the pointer of the variable tree, and then left subtree and right subtree will be now. Okay, you can write this one or not it doesn't matter because this one has already done before. Am I right? And then you can just simply and else if the tree is not now, so it's not the initialization. Initialization is not right. This one is initialization, but this one is not right. So it's not, so there are some value in the tree. So what should we do? The first step is we have to to set up the parent pointer to now. Okay, parent pointer will be the parent pointer of the current pointer, and then node pointer will point to the tree. So the tree is the you point to the root, right? So you have to use the node pointer in order to traverse along this tree. So you can use node pointer, and then you can traverse along this tree by using y. Node pointer is not equal to now. So this one is the repeat step, right, or the loop, right? So it's very easy, right? It's very easy because you have to check out about the data. Right, the parent node, right? The node pointer is a parent node. It's assigned to the parent node. And then if the value is less than node pointer data, right, the current data, right? For example, if you have the 47, right, and the value is, let's say, 20, is the value is 20, so you have to go to the left subtree. So the node pointer will change to the node pointer that point to the left subtree. Okay, otherwise the node pointer will change to the node pointer of the right subtree. This is the way that we are traversing along the tree. Okay, when you are considering the what we call the value, you're considering this value. If value is less than, go to the left. If the value is greater than, go to the right. Okay, once you go to the correct place, I will say that it's not the correct, but we will go to, we will do this loop until the node pointer is equal to now. Once the node pointer is equal to now, then the parent pointer will point to the current value or not. If the parent pointer data is less than value, so the parent pointer to the left will point to the pointer. Okay, the pointer is the node that is going to be inserted. And then once we find the place, then appropriate or the proper place to be linked, okay, which is the parent pointer, okay? So the parent pointer will point, okay, if less than the value is less than the parent pointer data, so the parent pointer left will be point to the pointer. It means that this one is a parent pointer, 47, and this one, the new value is 20. So the parent pointer left, this one is a parent pointer, right? Parent pointer left point to the pointer, right? When 20 is less than 47, 20 is less than 47. If I write a figure in order to show this one, this line of the instruction, say instruction, right? It will be like this, okay? Otherwise the parent pointer, right, will be point to the pointer, okay? Pointer is the new node. Okay, this is the way that we will do if you want to insert a new element into the binary search. I think you have already done this one yesterday, and I hope you will try to, first of all, you maybe try to understand and memorize the way or the way of writing this code, this piece of code. But I hope that you will not just only understand, but you have to be able to remember and apply for your future programming, okay? So this is the insert a new node. Okay, This is what we are going to insert a node with the value 12 and 55 in the given binary search tree. So what should we do? So you have to compare 12 with the 45, right? It's less than, so we will go to the left, right? And then once we come to here, we come to the 39, right? But 39 is the left and the right pointer is now. So in this case, 12 is supposed to go to the left of the toward 39, right? It's supposed to be here. So the current pointer will point to here. And then once we go out of the loop, right? If you see the previous loop, so you have to put 12 on the left-hand side of 39. So that's all for inserting new node with the values 12. How about 55? 55 is similar, right? 55 is greater than this, right? 55 is greater than 45, and then we'll go to the right, and then compare 55 with 56. Right, 55 is less than 56, so you will go to the left. So now we have 54. 54 is less than 55, right? This is a given number. So you have to allocate this one, this new node, 55, and then link this one to the right, like link of 54. Okay, this is still okay for you, right? Okay, then I will go to the next operation that is important as well for the deletion. If you want to delete a node from the binary tree, right? We will have four cases, right, that you have to consider. So we will start from the first one, that is the easier one. Right, delete a node that has no children. What does it mean by how can we call the node that has no children? What is the specific name of this node? Can you type it? A node that has no child. Okay, yes, thank you very much. The leaf node, that's right. What is the, Panawat, what did you say? What is the that icon name? I don't understand. Oh, a leaf node. Okay, leaf node. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm too old. Okay, I cannot see that. Okay, I thought that is a like a flame pyro. Okay, that is a leaf actually. Okay, how can we do? What is the nature of the leaf node? The nature is leaf node, is leaf. The leaf node, we have no children. So left and right link will be now. Am I right? Suppose this is a node, right? This is an element, right? For the left node will be now, so the right node will be now as well. Now and now. Now and now, am I right? So in this example, we want to delete a node from the node 78. So first of all, you have to find it. Have to go from 45 and then to the right, and then to the right, and then delete. So this is very easy, right? You can just simply delete this by set by set the 56 right pointer, suppose pointer is here, right? Pointer to the right will be set to now. Am I right? And then what we have to do is you have to remove this one as well. Remove means remove from the memory. If this one is the next pointer, you have to free this memory, right? Okay, in C program, if you want to remove this node from the primary, from the main memory, you need to use the function free node, free next pointer. Okay, if this one is a next pointer, you can delete it. And then you have to, don't forget to reset the pointer right by now. Okay, you have to set now to the pointer right of the current position. Actually, the current position is the parent node of the current position that is going to be deleted. Okay, this one is simple. Okay, so here I will go to the next one. What is about the case two? Delete a node with one child. Okay, for this example, if you want to delete 54 is here. You have to traverse along the binary search tree and to find the 54, right? And once you can see that 54 has only one child, right? So what should we do? We want to delete this one, right? You want to delete this one and then 56 left subtree or left link of the 56 will point to this one. Am I right? This is what you are going to do, right? This is the deletion. Delete a node with one child. Or in order to make it easier, just one child. So then you can just replace 54 by 55. And then free 55 here, and that's all. Do you understand? When you can find the place that you are going to eliminate, right? So you can just simply replace each child with this 54 by here, and then remove 55 or free 55 here. So this is the way. This is the second case. Okay, how about the third one? Deleting a node with two children. Suppose we want to delete a node 56. Where is 56? 56 is here. Okay, what should we do? We are going to delete 56. The easiest way is to move 54 or 55 to here. Am I right? So when we move 55 to here, you can get 55 here. And then you delete this one. So you can get the tree like this. So this is case by case, okay? So you have to be careful about how to delete the node, right? In order to delete a node, right, you cannot delete it. Okay, what I'm trying to say is that if you want to delete this, you cannot directly delete this. You cannot free node 56. Because why? Because if you free this one, right, this will point to nowhere. Okay, once again, right, if you found that this node is going to be deleted, and then you delete it from the tree, what's happened to this one and this one? It will be floating anywhere and cannot be connect from the root node. So what you have to do is you have to keep this one, to keep this data structure here, but change only the value. But which value you are going to place it? You have to select from 55 and 80, right? But if you select 80, 80 cannot move to here because 80 is greater than 78. So you have to do more. But in order to make it to make sense, you have to go to the right of the left subtree, to the rightmost of the left subtree, because the rightmost of the left subtree is very close to this one. Okay, let me write. Find the rightmost node of the left subtree. This one is left subtree of 56, right? You have to go to the rightmost of the left subtree. That's why we select 55, right, in this case. And then 55 will be to this one. You go to this. And then delete. Don't forget to delete this one. Okay, I'm not going too fast, right? You can still follow me, right? Okay, I will go to the last case, right? We have only two cases. Okay, this one is a way that you are going to okay. Oh, this one is another algorithm, right? If you want for the previous algorithm, if you delete 56 here and then you want to find or to promote the rightmost node to here, right? So it would be like this. It just, you can just simply do only four step. But this is the next one. If you want to promote, okay, you want to delete this 56, right? And then you want to promote. How can I call? The leftmost of the light subtree. Of the right subtree. Promote the left mode of the right subtree. What is that? Because 78, right, and 78, you don't have the left subtree. So itself will be the left mode of the right subtree. So you have to promote. Right? You replace 56 by 28, and then you have to move 80 to here, right? So here will be 80 and then delete this one. Okay, so you can select any of these two algorithms. Promote the leftmost of the right subtree or the promote the rightmost of the left subtree. It's up to you. Which one is easier? The results are different. The results are different. But you can still have the binary search tree for this deletion. Once you want to delete an element from the binary search tree, the main regulation or the main rule of this one is you have to keep the binary search tree as the binary search tree. Do you understand? You have to keep it to be itself, to be binary search tree. What is binary search tree? So you have to go back to the definition of the binary search tree that if you are considering the root, right, the right subtree, or the right subtree will be greater than the root, and the left subtree will be less than the root. That's all. That is the rule for the binary search tree. Okay, here is the algorithm for deleting a node from a binary search tree. Okay, and I forget to put the program here, right? Sorry for that, right? You can see it in the chapters 10, right? The algorithm is there, right? And I'm not going to talk into it. Do you have any question? Are you still there? Okay, thank you for your reply. I see here. Okay, thank you very much. Because after this, we are going to talk about the some functions in binary tree, binary search tree, right? And then I will go to the balance tree. Okay. Okay, before we go to that, we also have the threaded as well. Do you want to have a break for 5 minutes and then we will come back? Okay, we have a short break, right? So you can walk around. Your house and then. In 5 minutes, okay. Okay, I come back. Okay, the next topic that I would like to introduce to you, that is not difficult. I think if you want to find the height of the binary tree, right, what should we do? So you can write a program, recursive program like this, right? First of all, you have to set the local variable left height and right height. What should we do is, first of all, if tree is now, right? You have the if and else. If tree is now, so the height is zero. But if not, right? So you have to do the recursive function height of the left subtree. And right height will be the value of the height of the right subtree. Okay, and then, so after these two sentences, so you will get left and right height, right, of the tree. And then if left height is greater than right height, so you will count the left height is the height of the tree, and then you plus one. Otherwise, return right height plus one. Okay, this is a way that you are going to find the height of the binary tree by using the recursive algorithm. Okay, by using the recursion. Okay, you can just simply find the height, the maximum height between the left subtree or the right subtree. And then you just simply plus one. You can get the height of the tree. So it's very simple. And if you want to count the nodes in the binary tree, so you can do similarly, right? You can find the total node in the left subtree and total node in the right subtree, and then plus one. One is the root. So you can use the recursive algorithm. You can use the recursive function as well. So you can see that if you know how to write a program in recursively, you can find that it's very easy, right? You can just use the recursion, okay, to find the remaining data structure. Mm-hmm. And this one is a program to find the external node of the binary tree. External node means the leaf, okay, the leaf node of the binary tree. And if you want to find the internal node, right, you can just use this one as well. Okay, so that's all for the binary search tree, right? If you want to try to practice how to write a program for representing the binary search tree, you can also use the program that has been provided in the chapter 10, right? And the next one, okay, in the past when I was studying the data structure when I was in the bachelor degree, right, I have never heard about this one, the threaded binary tree. It's just a special name or the new name that I have just found that, but I think it's quite interesting. Right, it is very interesting because you can use only one data structure and then you can operate or process it like a binary tree as well as a linked list. Why? Okay, I will start from the definition of the threaded binary tree. Threaded binary tree is the same as the binary tree as I just told you, right? But the difference is you have to, instead of sorting the null pointer, you will use null pointer in order to keep the spatial value or spatial links, right? In the link representation, a number of nodes contain a null pointer, either their left or right field or in both. But this space will waste the space, right? In sorting a null pointer, it can be used to store some value or some useful piece of information. For example, the null entry can be replaced to store a pointer to the in order predecessor or in order successor of the node. What does this mean? I will show you the picture, okay? And this special pointer we will call thread. And then binary tree containing threads are called threaded trees. Okay, it will look like this. Suppose you have the binary tree like this on the left hand side of this figure, right? You can have, okay, 1, 2, 3, maybe just only the label for each node, okay? To say that this one is a node 1, node 2, node 3, node 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, but we are not going to talk about this in terms of the binary tree or collect the data inside. Because if you want to collect it, it is a BST, right? 1, 2, 3, like this is not correct, okay? But I want to show you that for the threaded way, right? Once you have the node, the root node, right? Root node will point to 2, right? And 2 will point to 4, 4 will point to 8. This one is in order. If you want to make it to be in order representation, if you could remember, right, when we talk about in order, but if you traverse in the in order manner, you will get the value in ascending order. Right, it will be sorted from small element to the bigger element. Right, so that's why we call in order. So if you can make the binary tree without the null value like this, and then you point back, like it will show you like in order style or in order manner. For this example, 1 will go to 2, 2 will go to 4, 4 will go to 8, right? And then 8 will go to 4 again and then go to the right. That will be 9. And 9 will go to up to the root and then go to right. And here we'll go to this one back to the root. So now we have left root and right, right? And then here we come to right, we'll go to the leftmost and then go back to the root and then go here and then to the root and then right, right. This is the in order style, right? So you can see that instead of, we have the now like this, right? In order to sort now, right? We will point, we will use to keep the pointer back to its root. Or the next value, right? Once you do this, right, this one will keep, okay, this one back to like this. So when you keep it like this, you will get what? You will get the tree in the listed in the in order manner or ascending order. Okay, so this is similar to the previous slide, right? But it's written in terms of the node like this, right? Go to this way, and then back here, and then back here to this, and then go back here, and go this, and to the leftmost, and then go back to root, and then here, and then go back to the root, and then and so on, right? This is a threaded binary tree. Okay, instead of keeping now value in the, okay, that the value is supposed, the link that's supposed to be now, right? But we will point back to make it like a string, like a thread, right? Link like this, like a thread. When you follow this manner, you can get the ascending order, right? Ascending order. We have one-way threaded binary tree, but and we also have the two-way threaded binary tree as well. But once you want to go, okay, to come to this way, like leftmost, and then go here, and then have this, and then go there. This one will be like in ascending order. But if you want to go for the descending order, you can go in opposite way. Go to the rightmost here and then go back. And then go down, no, to here, then back here. Okay, so this is a way that you use two-way threaded binary tree that is more complicated, okay? To make it in two direction, right? Ascending order and descending order. Okay, all together in two-way threaded binary tree. That is more complicated. Okay. Okay, here is the list of the advantage of using the threaded binary tree. The first one is it enables linear traversal of element in the tree. Okay, that is obvious, right? And linear traversal eliminate the use of the stack, which is in turn consume a lot of memory space. Okay, when you use the binary search tree, right, the things that you always, the mechanism that you always use, that is the recursive style or recursive manner. When you use recursive manner, you need to use the stack in order to keep track of the recursion. Okay, so in this way, if you use a threaded binary tree, right, you can use a linear traversal. So that is a simple and no use. The stack is not necessary to be used. And then it enables to find the parents of given element without explicit use the parent pointers. So in this way, you may have to connect the current node with the parent. Normally when you have, you know, the parent and then you can know each child, so that's easy. But if you are the child, if you want to know it, your parents, you have to do the recursion, or you have to, you cannot find it at the current position. But using the threaded binary tree, you have you can know the parents of the current position or the current node. That is easy because it's linked to the previous or the current parents node. SIM nodes contains pointer to in order predecessor or in order pre-successor. The threaded tree enable forward and backward traversal of the node, right, in order fashion that I have already told you, right? In order fashion, in order is the forward, right? Forward and ascending, right? Normally in order, but if you use backward, right, you can get the descending order. Okay, you may have to put the star here, three star here, right? Okay, yeah, the advantages of the threaded binary tree. And this one is a program if you want to implement the threaded binary tree. If you have time, you can try to write a program. Okay, this one is an insert. Okay, for the insertion, it will be a bit more different to the basic binary search tree, but you may have to keep track on the binary search tree link, and also you have to keep track on the threaded binary search tree links as well. So the code will be more sophisticated. Okay, like this. Okay, you can try to see. And this one is the way to create the threaded tree and in order traversal. Okay, and this is the way. You can try this, right? You can just simply copy the code, the piece of code in your textbooks, and then try to compile and execute it, and then you can see how this program looks like. Okay, and I'm not going to detail. I just want you to practice this. But the most important thing, and that I would like to talk today, that is the AVL tree. AVL tree. I've just told you at the beginning of today's class, right, that is once we have the binary search tree, right, sometimes if you have the the sequence of the binary search tree, the sequence of the element of the binary search tree has been inserted in your tree ascending in ascending order, you will find the problem because the tree will not balance. The tree will be shown as the like a linked list. For example, if you insert 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, and so on, right? You can see that this one is not balanced tree. It's not a binary tree because there is no element in the left sub, the right sub tree, right? And it's not balanced. So in this way, in 1962, right? Adelson-Welski and Landis has been introduced a self-balancing binary search tree, right? In this year, right? AVLT as their name, right? Adelson-Welski and Landis AVL, right? The tree is named AVL in the honor of its inventors, right? The height of two sub trees has to be may differ by at most one. Right. Okay, this is the concept of the AVL tree, right? And sometimes AVLE can be known as a height balance tree. High balance tree. And the key advantage of using AVLT is it will take big O log n time for sure, right? Because you cannot find the worst case of the binary tree, right? That is as I just told you, this one is a worst case of the binary tree, right? This like a linked list. This one if you want to insert or if you want to find the value inside this tree, right, it will be big O n, right, which is the worst case, right? In order to eliminate this worst case, so you have to use the AVL tree. The feature of the AVL tree is it will be self-balanced tree. And the self-balanced tree, we have the two subtree, right? Two subtree will have the height at most one. The differ of the two subtree will be one. For example, if the right subtree is height is three, this one is four, right? Four minus three will be one. So this one is still balanced. But once this one is two, this one is four, four minus two is two, so this tree is not balanced and it is not AVL tree. Okay, so once we have the AVL tree and the tree is self-balanced, right? Self-balanced. So the number of the search or the search insert delete operation in average case will be limited to big O log n, as well as the worst case. Okay, so this will, AVL tree is a data structure that will eliminate the worst case scenario of the tree, right? Suppose you want to insert, you want to delete, right? So you don't have to worry about the worst case scenario because of this will be eliminated by self-balancing binary tree, okay? And the complexity of the searching or inserting or deleting operations will be big O, only the maximum of big O log n. Log n base 2 as well, big O log n base 2. Okay, this is our AVL tree. Okay, for this example, okay, how can we find the value to check whether this one is the AVL tree or not, okay? So for this example, let's start from the leaf node, right? 18, the value is zero because there is no left or right subtree, so there is no height. So the height will be zero minus zero, that is zero, okay? So considering 27, right? Left, you have one tier or one level, but this one is zero. So one minus zero is equal to one here. Okay. And this one, this is two minus one is one. Three minus 2 is 1. This one is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. Okay. So if the value is minus 1 or 0 or 1, it's still AVL3. Okay, so similarly, like if this one, left, right, this one is 1, right? Because this is a 0, this is 1. 1 minus 0 is 1. Okay, this one is 2, this one is 1, right? So you can get 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. This one, the height is 3. This one, the height is 2. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. Okay, can you follow me? If you want me to explain it again, please press 1 to the chat. This one is also balanced 3, okay, because it's minus 1. But this one is all 0 because it's very perfectly balanced, right? You can see that this one is 1 minus 1 is 0. And this one is 2, and this one is 2, the height. 2 minus 2 is also 0. So easy, right? So in order to check for the AVL3, it's very easy, right? You can just simply check for the left or the right. If the right is get the height of the right subtree is greater than left, so you can get the negative number like this. Okay, here we are. So what if we want to insert a node into an AVL3, right? What should we do? in insertion in an AVL3 is also done in the same way as it's done in binary tree. Okay, we can do the same thing as in binary tree, but we have to check for the value, right? The value of AVL3, right? If the value, if you insert it and then the value is not in minus 1, 0, or 1, right? You have to rotate. You have to rotate. I'm going to talk about the rotation in a jiffy, okay? But, okay, why do we have to rotate, right? The rotate will be done to restore the balance of the tree. But you have to rotate the subtree in order to make it balanced all the way. Okay, during insertion, the new node is insertion as a leaf node, so it will always have a balance factor equal to 0. Only the node whose balance factor will change are those which lie in the path between the root of the tree and the newly inserted node. Okay. So let's see the example. From this AVL3, right, if we insert the new value 30, where is 30? You insert 30 here, right? So you get minus 1. And this one is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. It's okay. Still okay. So it means that if you insert into the left subtree, right, you can just simply check for the value that has been changed only in the left subtree. So you don't have to touch anything. The value on the right subtree, okay? Okay, we have already talked about the balance factor, right? The balance factor will of all nodes is either 0, plus 1, or minus 1 for the AVL3. This is the definition of AVL3. So I've already talked about the rotation, right? There are 4 kinds of rotation in AVL3, right? We can call LL rotation or single R rotation, or RR rotation or single L rotation, or LR rotation or RL rotation. That's all of the 4 kinds of the rotation in AVL3. I'm not going to talk about the detail of the definition of each rotation, but I will show you the first one, what is going on this one. Okay, suppose you have this 3 and 2, right? So this one is plus 1, this is 0. Once you insert a new element, that is 1, right? If you insert this one, this will be 2 and this will be 0. So you can have plus 2. So plus 2 is not balanced, right? So this kind is insert left, insert new key into left subtree of left child, left subtree of the leftmost child, right? Because you want to insert 1, 2 here, right? Left subtree of the left child, that is LL. What should we do? Let's think like this. You hold this one and move it up. When you move it up, right, 2 will be promoted into root, and then 1 will be here and 3 will be here. Think about this one with this is like a bead, right? And you have a string, right? Tie this 2 bead, right? Once you have you hold this one, you hold this one as a root, so this one will be pointed to the left like this. But if you insert one more element here, so the this one, this node will be promoted. And promoted to what? To be a root node. If you move it up, right? If you move this bit up, right? You can have this one. So in this way, we call rotate, right rotate. That's why we call R rotation. And we call LL rotation because left subtree of the left child. That's why we call single R rotation. Single R rotation means rotate right, rotate to the right. So you can get tree view here. Do you understand? Do you get the point? Okay, let me introduce another one. Oh, similarly, insert new key inserted into left subtree of the right subtree, right? Suppose you have the tree like this. If you insert one more element here, now, this one is not balanced, right? So what you have to do is you have to promote this as a root, pull it up to root. And then if you pull this up root, right? So this one should be moved to connect to R, connect to R. T subtree will be changed to this. And then this one remain the same and C will be promoted to root. So this one is we call right rotation as well. It means that we insert left subtree of left child. Insert the left subtree of the left child. Left. Insert. This one is left subtree, right? Left child of the left subtree. Or left subtree of the left child. Left subtree of the left child is here. Insert here. Left child, right? Left subtree of the left child. But we are going to have the insert left subtree of the right child, insert right subtree of the left child, something like this. Okay, this one is a simple one. Okay, we'll start from a simple one, right? Left subtree of the left child. Left child is here. This is the left subtree, and then insert somewhere, anywhere in this left subtree. Okay, but will be inserted in the left subtree of the left child. So you can see that the result will be the balanced tree. The tree is balanced. Okay, this is LL rotation or single R rotation. Okay, let's just see the example. Consider the AVL tree, right, given in this figure, right? And then if you insert 18 into this one, into this tree, right? So it's not balanced anymore. So what should we do? So before we will go to balance the tree, right? So what first thing you have to do is you have to find the balance factor, right? So this one is minus one, but if you insert here to this, the balance factor is two. So it means that this AVL tree is not balanced. So what you have to do is, because you insert the left subtree of the left one, the left subtree of the left node, right? The left subtree of the left child. So it will be LL, right? So you will have to do R rotation. R rotation means promote this up to this left subtree up to root, right? So the 36 will be 36 like this. And then this one will be plugged into this, right? This one will be plugged to this, right? To be the left link of the 45 and so on. And this one is pulled over to this. Mm-hmm. And then you can get this one. So that's why we call right rotation. What's happened to me? This is a right rotation. Rotate to the right hand side. This one promote to this side. Okay, this is LL rotation or single R rotation. Okay, so in opposite, right, we have RR rotation. Insert right subtree of the right child. Right subtree of the right child. This is the root node, right? This is the right subtree or the right child. This one will be the right subtree of the right child. Okay, you insert new value tree here, right? So what you have to do is you have to promote this right child here to root. Yeah, right child here to root. And then you can have this one. And then in order to do this, right, it will be like left rotation. That's why we call single left rotation. Promote right child to root. Promote this right child to root. Right, and you perform the left rotation. So you can have from this one, this, right, rotate to left, so you can get this one. Okay, this way is, this method is the opposite of the LL rotation, okay? Let's see the example. Suppose you have this one, and then once you insert 89 here, and then you get minus two. What should we do? Insert right subtree to of the right node, right? Insert right subtree of the right child. Insert here right subtree of the right child. So promote right child up so you can get this one and rearrange this one again so you can have this and this one will be plugged to this. Okay, and this one will be like this. So when you calculate for the balance factor, you can get zero here. Don't be excited, right? For me, right, in the first time that I studied this AVL tree and the rotation, I was confused. I was frightened, right? But no problem, right? If you look at this carefully, you will understand it easily, okay? But it's just simple. Maybe you can just remember the first one and then you can apply to the second one, no problem, okay? But the best thing is that you have to understand four cases. Okay, we have two cases now. So RR or single L rotation. So suppose you have the balanced tree like this, and then when you insert any node here in this subtree, right? So it means that insert into subtree of the right child. Right child mean right child of the root. Okay, so what you have to do is you have to promote B to root. B is the right child of the previous root, okay? You have to promote this to root. But when you move it up, right? So this one will be A and T, T1, right? But you cannot have three legs for the binary tree, okay? Can you see this? You see that you have three legs right now, right? If you are trying to rotate left, right? You have one leg, two legs, three legs, okay? But you cannot do that, right? For what you have to do is you have to change this one to be plugged into this one. And this one will be deleted. Now, B will have one leg and two legs, that's all. And then you can get this one, B, A. And then this one is supposed to be belong to the left subtree of B, will be the right subtree of A instead. Okay? And the rest is, the remaining is, remains the same. Okay? This is called left rotation. Okay? Up to now, any question? Okay, if you don't have any question, I will go for two more, right? This may be a bit confusing as well. Okay, let's go to the next one. Are you ready to be confused? What a kind of teacher I am. Okay, the next one, the next case is LR rotation, as it name. Right subtree, when you want to insert the left child, the right subtree of the left child, okay, where is left child? Left child is this, but the previous case, right, you insert the left subtree of the left child, but in this case, you will insert the right subtree of the left child. Right subtree RL will be LR. Right subtree of the left child. What you have to do is you have to perform left and right rotation. If left and then right rotation, what's happened? Okay, if you insert two here, right? This is a right subtree of the left child. What you have to do is you have to promote. First one you have to do L rotation. L rotation means you have to move this to this. L rotation, you have to move this to this. That means one will be the promote and two will be promote to be the parents of one. Move. Can you see this? Left rotation, right? Left rotation. So promote two to here and then this to this. Okay, so this look like LL rotation. Do you remember? LR rotation is very easy if you find the relationship with the LL rotation. It means that if you insert to this, what you have to do is you have to change this to the LL rotation. Now here we have the LL rotation. So what you have to do next is you have to perform a rotation. So you can come up with this one. So that's why right subtree of the left child, you have to right, left, you have to do left, right. Similarly to the case of RL rotation, insert left subtree of the right child, insert left subtree of the right child. So what you have to do is you have to perform right rotation. So you can go to the RR rotation. Now is RR, right? Right. So then you have to perform L rotation. So you can get this. So that's all. That is easy. If you can understand the LL rotation, you can understand LR rotation. Okay. And then you can upgrade, right? I can call upgrade, right? To the like this, to the complex one, right? LR rotation, right subtree insert into right subtree of the left child, right? Right subtree of the left child is here. Insert anywhere. You can insert here, insert inside. It's up to you, right? But it's also the right subtree of the left child. Right subtree, this one is left child. This one is left subtree. Right subtree, of the left child. So here we are. Insert this element. So what should we do? So what you have to do is RL. So you have to do L and R. Okay. Right subtree of the left child, R of L. You perform L and then R. That's why we call LR rotation. Okay. So what you have to do is L first, L. So you have to promote what? Promote G up. What you have to do is, this is a left child, this is the right subtree, right? The root of the right subtree of the left child. So you have to promote G, right, to the root. And then left to the G, right, will be the right of C. And left and right of G will be the left of R here. Can you see this? Maybe this one is too fast, but can you see LR in this one? So you have to rotate this to this, right? And this one will be CC, right? And then you have to connect this to here, and G will be here, right? But this one will be longer, right? This is LL, right? And then once you have this, and then you have to perform rotate right. This one will be promote to root, and then it will rotate right. So T here will be here, and then C will be here, like this one, right? And then will be down to here, and then T4 will be here, and then you have to reconnect T3 to TT here. So this is the rotation. So first you have to do L rotation, and then once C is up, so perform R rotation. Okay, this is why we call LR rotation. If you have the complex subtree like this, because I don't want you to be confused about the RL rotation. So RL rotation will be in opposite of LR rotation. So today, you have to focus. You have to try to remember this one, how it can be done. So in order to make it easier, so we can talk about the example 10.5. Suppose we insert 37 into this tree. We insert 37 into this tree, right? So it is the insert into the right subtree of the left child. Right subtree of the left child. RL perform LR rotation. LR rotation, what does it mean? So you have to move this one. Okay, first of all, you have to check for the balance factor, right? These two. So you have to restructure it. In order to restructure it, so you have to promote this, right? So 39 will be, okay, 36 and 27. And then, where will we put the 37? The right subtree of 36, right? 36. And so on. So now we perform the left rotation. Am I right? And then once we have the left rotation, so we promote 39 up to the root, up to be the root, then you perform right rotation. So now 39 is here. And then 65 and they're supposed to be 63, but okay, right. Okay, 63 here and 45 will be here. Okay, promote this up. And then so we have the balance tree already. Mm-hmm. This one is LR rotation. If you insert new key to the left subtree of the right child, left subtree of the right child, you have to do LR, you have to do RL, rotate right first. So you can have this and then rotate left again. So, and these are the example of AL. So, that we have the technique that we will balance the tree if you insert something into the tree, right? So here we have to start from the sketch, right? So we have to start from the, if you insert 5 as the first element, so it's okay. Insert 6 into this is okay. But once you insert 8, right, it is right off right, right? So we have to do L rotation. So L rotation or left rotation, so you promote, instead of 5, you promote 6 to be root, and then 5 will be the left-hand side, left subtree, and 8 will be right subtree. So you have the balance tree here. And then you insert more, right? Insert 3, and then insert 2. Now the tree is not balanced. So what you have to do is insert left of left, so you have to do R rotation. A rotation means you promote. promote three, right? And then five will go to here, and then you pack two here, so you can get this. This is the right rotation. And then insert four. Four will be insert to the left, the right subtree of the right left child. The left subtree of the right child. So you have to do RL rotation. Insert right subtree of the left child. So you have to perform right subtree of the left child. So you perform right or left, right, left, right rotation. So rotate left first. How can we rotate left? Oh, I see. We have to promote five, right? And five will connect this, and four will connect to three, right? And then promote five. This one will be deleted, so you can have five, three, two, four, and then six, eight. Okay. Rotate left first. Rotate left, you can have five, two, three, right? No, five, three, two, and then four will connect to this. This one is left rotation. And then right rotation, you promote five, and then you have six and eight here. This is left right rotation. And once you have this, and then you insert five, seven here. Seven here will rotate left, rotate right first, so you can have or seven will be here, and then eight will be here. Rotate right first. Okay. And then we have six here, and then rotate left again, right? So six will be on the right hand side, on the left hand side of seven, and then plug into five. This step is interesting. Okay, now you will have the balance tree all the time. Okay, this is a summary of AVL operation, right? Left subtree of the left child. Left subtree of the left child, promote left to the root. So you will have a rotation, single R rotation. Left, right, or right, left. So you promote right subchild, or right subchild of left to root. So you will have LR rotation. And right subtree of right child. This one is RL, this one is LR. And right, right, you will have the single L rotation. RR, single L rotation. Left, right, right, left rotation. Promote left child of the right child to the root. Okay, this is a summary. Okay, I think you have many questions now, but I asked you to recall about this again, right? You have to check for the this one because for the first time you study in this class you cannot understand for sure, right? But you have to try to understand about how to balance the tree. That is a thing that I asked you to do the this as a homework. Okay. And there are some application of the tree that is our redback tree. Redback tree is another kind of the balance tree as well. And we also have the B tree and 2-3-tree, right? Once you have the many legs of the tree, okay? I'm not going to teach you, I'm not teaching you in this course, right, about this kind of trees, but only AVL is enough, I think. So my homework is that, okay, I think that's all for today's class, right? If anyone who didn't type anything in the chat box, please type one into the text, the box, right? So I can know that you check for the class attendance already. And okay, I think that's all for today's class. And if you don't have any question, oh, okay. The homework is that I want you to and try to understand this AVL operation. Okay. And now here we 2 hours already for today's class. Okay, if you don't have any question, you can leave the group. Okay, thank you very much for your attendance and your attention as well. Thank you for your attention and your attendance. Thank you, Pompanot. Thank you, Sakonkit. Have a good day. Bye bye. I don't know if you will have a good day or not because after finish AVL 3, right, it would be a bit messy. Okay. See you next week.